It's already quarter four and Christmas is quickly approaching. If you haven't already started sending in holiday products to sell on Amazon FBA, then you will want to start immediately. One way to source products during the holiday season is to do online arbitrage. In this video, I'll bring you along on a virtual sourcing trip using Tactical Arbitrage's reverse search feature to scout products your competition is already selling. For those of you who haven't heard of Tactical Arbitrage, it is an online software that lets you source a very large selection of online stores. They have a few different methods you could use for searching for products, but today I'll be using the reverse search feature. This method lets you grab all the ASINs and UPCs from your competitors and then use it to search on their platform and search all the stores in their database. Let's dive right into my computer and start sourcing. The very first place we want to start off is on Amazon.com because we're going to be looking for competitors and sellers where we could take a list of UPCs and ASINs from. There are a couple different ways to do this, but I'm just going to go into the search function and type in some type of toy that is currently selling. So for instance, Jurassic World, send that in. Then you just want to click on one of these listings. I'll open it in a new tab. You want to scroll down to the new options. Click that. And then what I'm going to look for is sellers with over 1,000 ratings. So like for example, the seller has 88,000 ratings. So we'll open that in a new tab. This one has 1,500. Open that in another tab. This one has over 3,000. Open that in another tab. All right, so now we have five potential sellers. Go to the seller page. Go down here to products. So the next thing we want to do is scroll down to the bottom and you want to check if they have 150 pages. The reason we want to do that is because the next thing we're going to do is use an extension that used to be called Storefront Stalker Pro, but is now called Tactical Expander Lite. And what that does, if we click up here, you get all ASINs from this seller slash page. It'll download up to 150 pages. Once you have the 150 pages, you want to pick TA for Tactical Arbitrage. For the file name, I use just the name of the seller. So I'm going to do that for the other sellers, and then we'll jump over to Tactical Arbitrage and start uploading these. So out of those five I opened, only two ended up actually having 150 pages, so I download those two. And now we're on Tactical Arbitrage's homepage, so we can go on here and start uploading these and scanning these lists. From here, you want to go over to the left, hit reverse search, reverse search. So when you're on this page, you just want to go to import bulk product codes. You want to hit upload new, and then you want to choose the file on your computer that you downloaded using Storefront Stalker Pro or Tactical Expander Lite. So I have the file selected, hit upload. You want to make sure it's UPC and ASIN. Upload. Now, if you don't know what all these different features are on Tactical Arbitrage, I'll link it down below or in the card up top. I have a playlist of Tactical Arbitrage videos that I made that give you a very good introduction to Tactical Arbitrage and go over all these different features, and it also shows you how to set up your filters so you can filter out the products and the results you're going to get from this search. But we're going to hit search so we can start searching. Now, these searches don't take long at all, so I'm going to upload a couple more searches and then we're going to go through them. Now, the one thing to keep in mind is I've been doing these searches for the past week or two just to start getting some ideas of what products are hot and what's selling, because it's also a good way to get an idea of what to look for if you do retail arbitrage as well. You can find products, get an idea of what's selling, and when you go out in the store, you could narrow down your search instead of scanning everything. You have an idea of what to look for. So let me go upload a couple more files, scan those, and once all the results are ready, I'll come back to you. So I uploaded a couple more lists from a couple more sellers, and now we're ready to go through the results. Before we do, if you find this helpful at all or interesting, don't forget to drop a like, drop a comment down below, or just smash that subscribe button. Let's get into it. So we're here on Tactical Arbitrage on the dashboard, and what you want to do is go over to the left-hand side and hit Search Manager. You have your queued searches, which are the ones currently running, if you have any of those, and then you have your completed searches. So we're going to scroll down, and it's the first one I did, but you can see it added 3,000 products, which most likely means that it screwed up on the filters, so it didn't properly filter out results, because normally you won't have this many good products come out. So we're going to skip that one and go to this one. Hit view data. Now, as I mentioned before, I've been doing this for a couple weeks just to find a couple extra products to send into Amazon. And from my experience, a lot of these products are sold out at the store. So we're going to first check whether they're in stock. Scroll over here and you're going to hit the title. So this is at target.com. Click that. And you can see the first result sold out. So that's one of the first things I'm going to do is just go through results and see if there's anything in stock. Because unfortunately, there's a lot of out of stock right now, which is why this is a great time to do online arbitrage or retail arbitrage. Because everything going on in the world and how bad the supply chains are, if you can find a product that people are looking for, then most likely there is profit to be made. I just finished going through all four of those pages, which was 31 products, and all the products I looked at were either sold out or products I'm currently gated in. So unfortunately, this first reverse search was a bust and I didn't find anything. So I'm gonna go over to the other ones and start searching through them and come back to you if I could find something to show you. So after going through the rest of the results, which altogether was about 130 items that Tactical Arbitrage found that could potentially be profitable, most of them being out of stock or gated items, I did find one that has some potential, but I'm kind of on the fence on. But then I did see that I'm gated in it, so I can't sell it anyway. I'm going to show you the product and show you my thoughts on whether I would buy it or not if I was on gated, which I think this one does have potential, but it is a little risky. So let's take a look at the product. You can see here on Target, it is available. It is $45.99 for 50 Hot Wheels cars. Since it's in stock, the next thing we check is Amazon. The first thing you'll notice is the box is slightly different. This one has a see-through front and this one does not, but it is still a 50-pack basic car. So that's one of the first things you want to check is making sure the item you're buying from a retail store is the same as the one that you're going to be selling on Amazon. Sometimes you'll notice companies change packaging every year or every other year. So this product looks like it's pretty much the same, just a different packaging. The other thing you check is how long it's been on Amazon with Keepa. And you can see if we scroll down here, it's been on Amazon for almost 3,000 days. So it's been on here a really long time. The next thing I would check on the Keepa graph is whether or not Amazon sells this. And you can see this gray part here. Amazon was selling it for a long time and just sold out now, which is why the price is elevated. So normally with a product just right off of this graph, I would be hesitant to buy it because most likely Amazon will come back in stock and then the price will go back down. You're stuck holding the product. But the one thing we can check is going back over a year. And you can see last Christmas, because this is an older product, that Amazon sold out around November 30th. And then the price was elevated. And it wasn't until almost March that they had consistently had it in stock again. And if we go back all 2,850 days, you could see around Christmas every year, Amazon tends to sell out of this product. So you can see here in January of last year, go back to 2018, and it's also elevated. And you could see these blank parts every year around Christmas. So with this product, this might be a good product to come in, buy a couple units, throw it up on Amazon, sell them out by January, make your money, and then you wouldn't restock this product again until next Christmas. So this product does have potential in that regard. That's why I said it's a little risky, because if Amazon does come back in stock, you're going to be stuck holding it. But it looks like based on the history of this product that you could make a quick flip and get out. The next thing we want to check though is if we are going to buy this and sell this in that small time frame we have while Amazon's out of stock, we want to check whether we make enough money to do this. So the extension I use for this is Amazon Scout Calculator. So I'll click this and hit run Amazon Scout Calculator. And you can see the product price is here at $99.99. So you can confirm, scroll up, new at $99.99. So if you go back to last year, you could actually see what it was selling for when it was out of stock at Amazon. And you can see third-party FBA was around $81 here, went all the way up to $100 and was still selling, just not as much as when it was a cheaper price. You also see this really high spike back in 2018, where it went up to $162. Based on a $99.99 sales price and a $45.99 price tag, we would make about $31 per unit, which is a net margin of 31%. And an ROI of 68.71%. So this is a product I'm kind of interested in purchasing, but the next thing I check, I grab the ASIN, you go over to Seller Central, you wanna go to inventory, add a product, and then here you wanna type in the ASIN you grab from the listing. And you can see here when I search it, I can't sell it, and I can't even apply to sell it. I believe during quarter four, Amazon doesn't really let people apply to sell products in the toy category. Unfortunately, I'm not able to sell this product, so I won't be purchasing it from Target. But if you are engaged in Hot Wheels already, this might be a good option. As I said, I probably wouldn't buy too many units. One, because it's expensive, but two, you don't want to get left holding them if Amazon does come in stock. Hopefully this breaks down the process of using reverse search on Tactical Arbitrage to scan through your competition's products to see if you could sell any of them. You just gotta grab Storefront Stalker Pro, so you could grab the list of UPCs and ASINs from their storefront, and then you wanna go over to Tactical Arbitrage, upload it, search it, and then see what results come. From the results, you use things like Keepa, Amazon Scout Calculator, to determine if you wanna sell that product, make sure you're gonna make enough money, make sure you can sell it, that you're not gated, and then once you decide whether you wanna buy it or not, you wanna go through and purchase it. There are other things you could do to make sure you're making a little bit more profit, like using discount gift cards to get a little bit extra percentage off. That's why I did $45.99 from my purchase price instead of doing $45.99 plus sales tax, because the gift card basically cancels out sales tax for me. Now, if you do want to learn more about Tactical Arbitrage, I have a beginner playlist for you that goes through reverse search, product search, and always be scanning. I believe there's 3 or 4 videos in that playlist, which I'll link right here. And don't forget, if you want more videos like this, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. As always, thanks for watching.